talking about, you know, gunboat diplomacy, as we've been seeing in Jersey, let's talk about diplomacy when it comes to the G7 talks. We saw G7 foreign ministers meeting in London this week, and then we saw the entire Indian delegation being forced to self-isolate after two COVID cases were detected in rather bizarre circumstances, because for some reason, nobody remembered to send a memo to the COVID virus that they were not supposed to infect people arriving on diplomatic passports, who therefore were not required to self-isolate or to quarantine in a travel lodge at Heathrow, but were allowed to take part in these G7 talks with all the other foreign ministers attending here in London. And they've been forced to self-isolate. And let's talk about this with Dr. Jade McGlynn, who's Director of Research at the Henry Jackson Society. Jade, I think a lot of people who've just been watching this closest think this is utterly extraordinary, that there should be this exception for politicians, diplomats. We've seen a case of a Whitehall a staffer returning from meetings in Brussels with COVID positive, not forced to self-isolate, not even take just a few days at home, just in case. The Indian delegation could possibly have infected goodness knows how many people, not having to follow the same rules that everybody else has to follow. Now, either we need these rules to keep us safe or we don't.
I couldn't agree more. I think it's completely bizarre. It doesn't make any sense. These rules are there for a purpose, for a public health purpose, moreover. So it's just completely, it's mindlessly insane that they're not expected to isolate. And as we've seen, this, it just shows how reckless it is with the Indian case. And there's also a very bitter irony that the Indian Foreign Minister Jaishankar is now self-isolating, given that he had called on Indian diplomats around the world to counter the global media's apparently unfair coverage of India's COVID crisis.
Yes, I mean, there is a certain irony there, isn't there? I mean, again, there was some criticism of the government, of Dominic Raab and Boris Johnson, for going ahead with an in-person summit. But we know there is a serious purpose to these summits. We know, and particularly, you know, the Western democratic leaders meeting up to show a show of unity to the saber-rattling that's going on by you know, the Chinese and the Russians at the moment. I have to say, it would appear the French right now in Jersey. There is a point to having face-to-face meetings, and we know this in the world of business. We know this in our personal relationships. Seeing people face-to-face, getting the cut of someone's jib, seeing them eye to eye, is very different in terms of getting things done. There is a purpose to having red list countries where you can't directly fly into from, and having quarantine. I mean, I'm not a big fan of the quarantine hotels and the like, but forcing people to isolate and take tests before and after. I mean, the idea that, oh, well, but because it's diplomatic and there is a greater purpose, you don't have to obey the same rules, is utterly bizarre, because no one tells the virus that.
No, exactly. As you say, the memos seem to get lost on the way to the virus. It's completely bizarre. And it's also really deeply unfair as well, that some people have to stay in a, quite lovely travel lodge.
Or whatever hotel it is. Other enforced quarantine hotels are available.
My bad. So it seems very unfair. I agree with you that it's really important for business and particularly for diplomacy. It's very hard to practice doing diplomacy. So I do think that's important. But again, this is just about being sensible. If you have a country where the virus is completely raging through that country, the country's on the red list, then that country, particularly when they're not actually a member of the G7 as well.
Yes.
Perhaps they can dial into that particular meeting.
Yes, that might have been sensible. Yes, better luck next time, Dr. Jade McGlynn, Director of Research at the Henry Jackson Society. Thank you for that. No,